Hello, hello, hello. I hope you guys can hear me because I have loud music playing in the house. So let me wait for a couple of you guys to join the live. As Instagram loves to tell me, hang on, we're telling more followers to join your live. So I'm going to wait for a couple of you guys to join the live and then we're going to get started on... I am starting back my educational videos, lives, posts. And once I'm done here with it, you guys that joined late, missed half of it or whatever, I'm going to add it to my YouTube channel. So you guys can go over there and take a look. I am so happy that we made 1,000 followers on YouTube. So now on YouTube, I can go live, and once I do the live on YouTube, I can just upload it there one time. So I'm gonna try playing around with that. Maybe I'll advertise on Instagram when I'm gonna go live on YouTube, and then it'll just upload automatically. Because normally what I do here is do the live on Instagram, save it to my phone, and then upload it on YouTube. So we are coming back to the roots of Surgery Bay. Today I had a little, I don't know, epiphany or a little come to Jesus. A little light bulb went off and I was like, you know what? I have been so busy taking up with in the last, because I just realized I haven't posted a video on YouTube for like 2 months. So I realized that I have just gotten so taken up with doing business, you know, taken up with life and dealing with whatever, contracts, financial stuff, day-to-day runnings of whatever, that I kind of stopped doing what I'm known for, you know, which is educating the masses, which is empowering women, which is educating you guys on plastic surgery in the Dominican Republic. Because I can't talk about Miami or Colombia because I've never had surgery there, right? So I can talk about what I know and what I'm good at. So today's live, it may be a little short one, it may not be that long, because I have other things to do. So also, you know, with the people's attention span, they can't stay motivated for too long to look at that video. And we definitely know they don't like to read. So I want to talk about today additional charges that you may occur, that may occur when you come for surgery, I'm sorry, in the Dominican Republic. So things that you did not budget for, that you weren't aware that you were going to be charged, things like that, that, you know, let's say you didn't bring money. And then what do you do? So some of the things that you need to be aware of that you may have incurred, and this is people who are, if you have any health issues, you guys are at even higher risk for this, because if you did not get clearance, so let me start from the beginning. You're coming to, and I'm on my balcony, guys, and there's cars and stuff passing in the street, so if you guys are hearing loud noise, that's why. Hopefully you guys can still hear me. So first of all, when you're coming down here to the DR for plastic surgery, if you guys think that the doctors here in the DR do very intense, in-depth medical analysis of your health, you are sadly mistaken. Usually labs day when you come for surgery, right? So some doctors, they have different requirements. Some may tell you they want you here in the DR 5 days prior to surgery. Some may tell you 3 days prior to surgery. Some may tell you 2 days prior to surgery. Typically, if you're coming from America, your flight is, your longest flight, let's say it's 4 or 5 hours, you can come to the DR, I would say, 2 days before surgery. So to give you guys an idea what I'm talking about, let's say you get to the DR on Sunday, so you land on Sunday 3 p.m. Sunday night, you cannot eat from, let's say, 9 p.m. After 9 p.m. no solid food, just water until midnight. The reason why is because the very next day, Monday, is labs, right? You don't want to eat a big bowl of pasta, a big bowl of rice or whatever, then the next morning you go and do labs, and when they draw your blood and they test your blood glucose, whatever, your liver enzymes, all these other things that they test, your numbers come back really high. And then they tell you, oh, ma'am, you're diabetic, you're pre-diabetic. Okay, so we can't do surgery tomorrow, Tuesday. You're going to have to see some additional specialists to get additional testing done and to get the approval from these specialists. So I can tell you guys from my own personal experience what happened to me for my round one. So you can learn from this and not do this. Round one, 2018, I did not know what I just said to you. So your girl was eating, whatever time of the night. The next morning where I was staying, I stayed in Mirador del Sur, which is like a really big park out here. And outside the park have these coconut vendors and they sell the fresh coconut. So if you guys don't know, coconut water is also high in sugar or glucose. He said to me, your blood glucose is 235. I mean, so since that's saying the numbers are saying that you're diabetic, and I wasn't, you now have to see an endocrinologist and a cardiologist. The endocrinologist and the cardiologist has to give their approval for me to have surgery. So that was on and those days. Now I'm pretty sure it's more. I think it's like 200 per specialist. In those days, I paid, and then I think it was Dr. Lawrence's friend, so he had them give me a discount. I think I paid $50 to each of them, but from my understanding, now it's $100 to $200 per specialist, or more, depending on who you're seeing and what you're seeing them for. So I had to see the endocrinologist and the cardiologist, pay them their fee, and then we did the like fasting, and then tested my blood again the next day. And then I was like, I think a fasting number, I think I was 103. So 100 and under is not diabetic. So, you know, I had my surgery. But that's one of the main reasons. Hey, Rosa. One of the main reasons why before you go and do your labs, you want to make sure that you don't eat and drink a lot of stuff that couldn't give false readings. Lab day is going to consist of getting your blood drawn, giving a pee sample, getting a chest x-ray, and getting an EKG. That is it. So there is no in-depth testing of anything. Now, when those numbers come back from your blood work, I've had dolls that message me, customers that message me, and said to me that they were told they had a fatty liver, and they had to see a gastroenterologist. And now their surgery is postponed even more because now they have to go see the gastroenterologist, pay whatever that fee is. Then usually they get some kind of medication to take before surgery. That's how much money you have to spend for that now. And then now your surgery is delayed. So now you have to make a decision. Do you want to stay longer in the DR after surgery so you have enough days in the DR for massages and stuff like that? Or do you want to cut, you know, your trip short because now your surgery is postponed by, let's say, 2 days or whatever, and you're gonna have less recovery time before you go home? That's your decision to make. For me personally, if you can stay in the DR 3 weeks to a month when you have a tummy tuck, it would be so beneficial for you not to go home with any set of issues, incisions busting open because you have fluid accumulating. Whether you live in America, England, wherever you live, your masseuse does not know about aspiration with a needle, or they don't know techniques. You know, full stop, I was drilling with the needle. Give me 1 second, guys. Let me take my Wi-Fi off because I don't know what's going on, but it keep pausing. So hopefully that'll stop the pausing that we keep having. So yes, some doctors, like I said, may want you to come really early. Okay, I guess the internet doesn't want me to be great today with the constant pausing of the video. So anyway, check with your doctor. Let them know your flight so they can tell you if they want you here 5 days, 3 days, 2 days before. But like I was saying earlier, typically, let's say you land on Sunday, Monday's labs, Tuesday's surgery. So people that are coming for 10 days, 14 days know that you're probably going to end up having 8 massages maybe. Yes, Trinigel, you know anything you're doing in life? She said, God, no. Them does fight you, young boy. Lord God. But you know what? That helps motivate me. That helps motivate me because I realize that the more good I do, the devil is so busy and so alive. And that negative energy, negative people, toxic people, they don't want y'all to be great. Because what I do it for y'all. I don't do it for myself. Right now I could be inside chilling, drinking wine, smoking a cigar, hanging out with my dog, hanging out with my friend that's in there, enjoying music, cooking. Actually, I am going to be cooking in a little bit. Cooking something really good. No, I'm here. Giving you guys my time, giving you guys whatever, it's an hour, 2 hours, whatever, talking to you guys about things that's going to prepare you for your journey, for your greatness, so that you don't make some of the mistakes I made. And that's something I realized today. I had a little, like I said, light bulb earlier. I was like, you know, I have lost that part of Sage Ruby the Page. I have not been doing that, what I'm known for the last couple of weeks, because I've been busy with the recovery house, busy with my trucking business and, you know, things like that. So I had to come back to that, and I started a new page called I Am Surgery Bay. I haven't done the profile and stuff as yet, but what I'm going to be doing is when I do lives and stuff on here, I'm going to start posting it on that page. I'm going to continue posting when I do these videos here onto YouTube. I know I'm not active in the Facebook group, and I really need to do that. I need to get more active in the Facebook group with you guys. But it's so many social media platforms, it's crazy. It's crazy, you know, just trying to keep up with all of that. So, a bear dolly. My doctors require typically 2 days prior for surgery for you to get here. Like I said, if you are going to get your surgery delayed for whatever reason, if it's a health issue, then your surgery might get delayed for 1 or 2 days when doctors are waiting for test results. So imagine doing whatever additional testing when you come down here because you didn't get this done at home, and your surgery being delayed for like a week. So you booked your recovery house for 2 weeks and you've been waiting a week to have surgery. Or like one girl I know, she literally, she's from Canada, came down to the DR to have surgery. Before surgery, she said her hemo was like 14, but she suffers from really heavy periods. I honestly don't know if her hemo was really 14 or not, but when she got down here, her hemo was 11.4, I think. She ended up staying in the DR for a month because she refused to go home without her surgery. So she did 1 week of iron infusions. Her hemo went up to, from 11.4, I think it went up to maybe 11.6, 11.7. She did a second week of iron infusions, and then finally it went up to 11.9. And you have to be 12 for surgery. But because it was 11.9, just 0.1 short of being 12, after the 2 weeks, they approved her surgery, and she had the surgery. So now she had, I think, breast lift and reduction, lipo, because the doctor did not want to do a tummy tuck on her because her breast was so huge that he had to, I think, spend like about 5 hours working on her breast. So she's going to be coming back for a tummy tuck later on. But she had to stay another 2 weeks to recover. So she ended up being here for a month. So you guys that do not get doctor's approval in America, in England, in the Caribbean, or wherever you live, that don't go and test your hemo before you come for surgery, that do not go and get clearance from your doctor or your specialist, know that when you come down here, you may think you're healthy, you think your hemo is good, you think everything is great and wonderful, and then when you come down here and they do your blood work and shit start popping up, or they do the EKG and they see that you have high blood pressure. Like I had one girl, same thing. She literally stayed in the DR for 2 weeks, didn't have surgery, and had to go back home. Why? She did not go to her doctor, get any kind of clearance, get testing done, whatever. Came down here and then found out she had high blood pressure. They gave her medication, whatever, to try and bring that down. It didn't work. So she literally was here for 2 weeks doing nothing. Anyway, get tested. go and get your blood work done. If you have sickle cell trait or sickle cell anemia, the actual disease, you will be denied surgery down here, or you will have to do a lot of damn testing. Because doctors down here, when they see that it comes up, it's called thalassemia in Spanish. When that pops up on your blood work that you are positive, whether it's the trait or the disease, they will send you for a lot of tests, blood work. And some of those tests take days to come back. Rosa said, I already have my request ready to go. With the sickle cell trait, they want to also get you tested to make sure that your blood clots. That's the main reason why they want to make sure that before they perform surgery on you, you're not going to bleed out. So there's different things that they test for in that. Aberdolly, if you go to my surgery bay, the Instagram page, I have a post on there that shows the different tests that the doctors ask for if you have sickle cell trait, that they want you to come with those test results and come with a letter of clearance from your hematologist saying, okay, we did these tests, she's fine, and you can have your surgery. Because of course your tests have to be a couple days, you know, from before you arrive in the DR. You can't bring these tests or this letter of clearance that's months old, you know. Rabbit Magic, yes, I do work with Duran dolls. The doctors that I do not work with, and I have no business or interest in working with them, and that's because of the feedback you see on the internet from these doctors getting burnt, getting maimed, is Desenia, Felix Almanzar, Yili, Natalie Bello. Those are the four doctors that I would say I don't want their dolls in my house, because I don't really want to deal with what's going on with possible post-op complications. Other doctors, Duran, Disla, Mercedes, Guidicelli, Cabral, Laurent, they're not known for maiming people, burning people horribly, disfiguring people. So I am okay with working, having those dolls stay at my house. And the doctors that I don't want to work with, that's one of the very first posts that I made on the Surgery Bay Recovery House page. But you don't have to be a doll of, and I don't even understand how people think. Why would I open a recovery house and only work with dolls that are going to the three doctors that I work with surgery bay packages? Like, those are two different complete entities. From, I don't know, just logically that doesn't make sense to me. But hey, look at the queen giving all the info. Love it. So proud of you. Thank you. I had to come back to my roots, what I'm known for, Megan. And today I had that light bulb go off, like, wait, you're so busy dealing with business that you're not giving time to what your platform is known for. So I'm back. I'm gonna post it here, the new Instagram page I created, which is only gonna be just about what I'm known for, knowledge, and it's called I Am Surgery Bay. You guys can say thank you to the trolls that love me, and that just kind of strokes my ego, to be honest. It just makes me realize that what I am doing is worthy, it's honorable, it's good. Because if I wasn't doing something that's good, people wouldn't be so invested in my success that my life would bother them so much, that they would take precious time out of their day that they could be spending with their children, their husbands, their family, their friends, doing something enjoyable, to report things on my page. And that's why Surgery Bay and Surgery Bay DR hasn't had anything on there, because the trolls have reported the page so many times for whatever they're reporting, I don't know. And to be honest with you, Instagram comes back and says, we are so busy with so many reports of whatever that we have not reviewed whatever it is you're reporting. But what does Instagram do? They just freeze, because it's an AI, it's an artificial intelligence. They freeze the pages. So those two pages, I can't do anything on it. So guess what? I'm not even going to be bothered. Those 50,000 followers, oh well. You guys love me, the ones that are my ride or die. You guys can find me on the internet, because I have various ways of being contacted. So once you said Surgery Bay, I Am Surgery Bay should come up. Hopefully it's not shadow banned yet by Instagram, and you guys will start seeing, I'm gonna start reposting all the knowledge on there, all the different videos, things like that. it's a work in progress, so I'm gonna have to take time out my day to download stuff and repost it and things like that. Rabbit to Magic said, if you weren't number one, they wouldn't come for your place. You said it, not me, because I'm not gonna toot my own horn, right? So we're talking about additional expenses you may have in the DR. So we talked about coming to the DR in advance, going and doing your labs, possible expenses you may have from those labs. If you are not in good health, you did not do labs in America, wherever you live, you did not get clearance from your doctor, so now you're in the DR and you have no idea, you have fatty liver, 2 more weeks. You didn't know that you may have high blood pressure, you didn't know you're pre-diabetic or whatever, you're pre-hypertensive and things like that. You come to the DR for surgery now, guess what? You have extra expenses. You have to go see these specialists. Go see these specialists, go get tested, go pay whatever, for whatever tests out of your pocket, go pay these different doctors, whatever their fee is. Wait to get the results back from your surgeon, whoever your surgeon may be, and then have surgery. So now you may have to extend your recovery house, stay longer in the DR, spend money for the driver to take you here, there, and everywhere. Because of course, it's not free. Gas is expensive. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. Gas is like $5 a gallon here in the DR, US. So yes, drivers do charge you $20-$25 per round trip for all these additional things that you... Hey, Simply Chic Nails! For all these additional runarounds that you have to do. Because remember, most drivers, they will charge you... my driver, at least. So the deal I made with him is to give you guys, who are my customers, whether you are staying at the recovery house as a recovery house customer and you have a different surgeon, or if you are a surgery bay package customer, he is charging $140. Other drivers are charging $175, $200. He's charging $140 to my people, and you're getting a round trip airport and 5 visits to the doctor, the clinic, whatever you need to do round trip. So anything other than those 5, because remember, lab day, surgery day, and then 3 follow-ups with your doctor would be the 5. So if you need to go to the mall, go to wherever, go do whatever, that's additional money you're gonna have to pay. So that's additional expenses, $20-$25 round trip, you know, for these additional charges after you've used up your 5 visits. I was denied because I didn't have clearance from my cardiologist because I have an irregular heartbeat. So I did get it, and he wrote mild risk but okay to have surgery. That was now almost 2 years. Do I need another recent clearance from him? Yes, you do. So let's say you're having surgery with Duran January, right? Let's give a date, January 15th. You want to at least have this letter of clearance from your doctor dated at least 1 to 2 weeks prior to coming there. I mean, as close to the date that you're leaving America to come down there, I would do that. Antibiotics and blood thinners, that's an additional charge. Your doctors do not, it doesn't matter if you're a surgery bay package customer or not, doctors do not include your medication typically with your surgery price. So they will give you your prescription for all the different medications they want you to take after surgery. You're going to usually get that the morning that you're being discharged from the hospital from your surgery, and then you know, you fill it however you want to fill it. What I do for my people at Surgery Bay Recovery House is you come with your prescription, my nurses will call the pharmacy will deliver to the house. You don't have to worry about going in the car, going with the driver, going to the store, you're in pain, you're tired, you're sleepy, you know, things like that. Our minors will call the pharmacy and have them deliver it to you. You can pay with US dollars, you don't have to have pesos, or your debit or credit card. And that's at a convenience where you don't have to worry about where am I going to find pesos to, you know, buy things that I need, whether it's go to the supermarket and get little things that you want. Example, some of you guys like apple juice, cranberry juice, that's, you know, Mott's or Ocean Spray, whatever. I don't buy things like that for my house. And the reason why is because those things have preservatives. They're sitting on the shelf for months, years, I don't know. I'm not giving you guys processed chemical stuff. Everything that I give you guys at the house is natural, organic, and fresh. The juices are made fresh. Like, literally, I buy limes by the dozens. I mean, like 100 limes at a time, to be honest with you. And the chef makes the lime juice fresh, like lemonade, limeade, however you want to call it. Passion fruit juice, pineapple juice, all of that is like fresh from fresh fruits. So if you want to go to the supermarket and buy Mott's and Ocean Spray cranberry and whatever, you can. I have no issue with that. You can give the nurse, they'll put it in the refrigerator in my kitchen. I have two refrigerators in the kitchen, so there's room for your stuff. However, I don't encourage, after surgery or before surgery, anything that's full of preservatives, at least for my customers to consume. I want you guys to have the best recovery because you're putting the most healthy, nutritious, you know, stuff in your body. Hey, my favorite page just joined. Hey girl, thank you for taking time out of your day to look at me and be so invested in my life and what I'm doing. I love it. Thank you. Anyway, so blood thinners, antibiotics. The doctors sometimes may give you, with your prescription, Tecasol, which you guys know is the antibiotic dusting powder. They may give you Presiderm, which is an antibiotic cream and ointment. They'll put iron, whether it's iron by tablet or liquid iron, vitamin C, omeprazole. You can bring things like this with you from America, wherever you live. If it's cheaper, go to Walmart and get it. Omeprazole is kind of like, it's not Zantac, but it's similar in the sense that it coats your stomach before you take all these different medications. Because remember, when you have surgery, you have maybe 4 or 5 different tablets to take. You can't obviously take all at the same time because you're going to feel sick. So we have a schedule, you know, at the recovery house. We also have a schedule where different times you're going to be taking, whether it's your omeprazole, a different time your antibiotic, a different time your blood thinner shots, things like that. So we keep track of everything that you're consuming, basically. Yes, Tecasol is like BMT powder, which is basically a surgical antibiotic dusting powder. Because guys, if you guys don't know, you are not supposed to keep your incisions wet. Slathering your incision with Neosporin or Bactine or whatever it is that people always tell you guys to do, you can't. You honestly, you cannot. So let's pin some comments. Okay, let's get rid of the trolls that want to take away blessings from you guys. So she just got blocked from viewing my live. I don't want to deal with, like I said, blocking you guys' blessings, which is going back and forth with anybody that is not doing anything in a positive light to help my life, myself, and you guys. No, I don't have many fridges in the bedrooms, and the reason why is because I am not encouraging people to bring cockroaches in my house. Which is, and I'll be very honest with you guys, I have already had customers that are nasty. Like, they have no home training. They're taking their, there is bathroom mats in each bedroom, 2, as a matter of fact. Depending on the size of the bathroom, maybe 1. But guess what they're doing? All these expensive towels that I bought, they're throwing it on the floor and staining it with blood and I don't know what else. Like, some of the towels, I had to throw them out because they're stained. Even though there's nice cotton fluffy bath mats on the floor, they are throwing the good towels on the floor. So this just goes to show you an example of how nasty people are that come to my house, and then they, I guess, go on the internet and talk shit about Surgery Bay Recovery House, but they're not talking about the zero home training that they have and how dirty they are as people. That being said, that's a main reason why I am not encouraging mini refrigerators in my room, in my bedrooms, because I don't want people bringing in all kind of snacks and food and leaving it there and leaving it on top of the fridge and leaving it in the fridge and leaving things nasty. No, you all see I have marble tiles in my house. I am all about that house being spick and span and pristine clean. Like, my staff, everybody knows if they see a dust, they need to wipe that. So, and nurses and the housekeeper. So I know we will not be having many refrigerators in the room. I have two big ass refrigerators in the kitchen. If you buy something in the streets and you didn't finish eating it and you want to bring it back with you to the house, the nurses are very happy to put it in the fridge for you, warm it up for you when you want to eat it, whatever. We always have bottled water that's cold in the refrigerator. If you guys go look at the video where I showed you guys the bedroom and stuff, you're gonna see every single bed has a number above the bed, so that when you ring the nurse call button, every single bed has a call button. The nurses know who's calling them, what room, what bed to go to give you whatever you need. And my nurses are there 24/7. These girls work 24/7 shifts. Literally, they work 24 hours and then they're off. So, excuse me. Whatever you need, you ring that button and they are there within seconds to answer and give you whatever it is that you need. So that was one question about the mini fridge. Thank you, Niptuck. Will you get denied if you're pre-diabetic? If your numbers are crazy, yeah. Like I was talking earlier about, I drank that coconut water and my numbers was like 235, but Dr. Laurent had me, actually he had me do the A1C test. So Portia, this is something you need to do if you are pre-diabetic. And then in those days I paid $50. And I had to go back to Central Medico to get it done. So this is my recommendation to you if you think you are pre-diabetic. JasonHealth.com. If you're not living in New York, New Jersey, this will work. If you live in New York, New Jersey, go over to Connecticut. JasonHealth, it's like $23 for the CBC with differential. And then to add the A1C, I think it's another $18, so you end up paying like $40. It's a little more on requestatest.com. Me living in Florida, I use both because I don't have an issue with being, you know, not being allowed to use those websites to do my lab work. So New York, New Jersey, you guys can't. You have to drive over into Connecticut to be able to do this, and you have to put a different address when you go on requestatest.com or jasonhealth.com to choose the lab that you want. So go to jasonhealth.com. And guys, if you guys are not understanding what I'm saying, somebody please type it in the comments so you guys can see it. It's literally called jasonhealth.com. And choose CBC with differential and choose A1C. So your CBC with differential, again, you want to do a fasting before you go give your blood. So don't eat for like 12 hours. Drink water only. Then get your blood drawn. The A1C test that they're going to do, if you guys don't know what A1C is, A1C measures the last 90 days of what you've eaten, basically. What you've eaten, and it gives you a number ranging from anywhere like 5 or whatever up until 9, 10. People have crazy numbers. So if your number is more than 6.5, when you get back those results, and with Jason Health or Request a Test, you normally get your results in 24 hours. If you're more than 6.5, they are going to deny you surgery. So the reason why they're going to deny you surgery is because if you're over 6.5 with the A1C, that means that you are a lot more susceptible to catching an infection after surgery. So that's why they won't do it. Like I had one customer, she was going to be a Mannion doll. She came with her hubby. Her A1C was 8.9. Sure enough, she did labs. The next day they told her, you can't have surgery. So she had to reschedule for 3 months, because every 3 months usually is when you test your A1C to see if she's getting her numbers down and stuff like that. Yes, jasonhealth.com. Click on to find a lab near you. Yes, thank you, Touch Body Studio. So for me personally, I need to go get my A1C tested, because guys, remember that I didn't have surgery in May because mine was really high too, and I didn't know I was on the wrong medication. So I've been taking what the doctor here in the DR prescribed to me, but again, your girl hasn't been consistent with drinking my water either, and eating properly, because guess what, I have been running around with this recovery house, running around with my trucking business, running around with my dog, running around with my hubby, running around with all kind of stuff. There was not enough time in the day, and guess what happened, I wasn't taking my meds, I wasn't eating. sometimes a lot of, most times for the day, I would eat once for the day, honestly. If people don't force me to eat, if my staff don't buff me and tell me eat something, or if the chef doesn't make me sit down to eat something, I swear I'm in and out, running around, doing stuff, not even taking care of myself. But I'm not complaining, because honestly, this is a labor of love for me. I feel like the day I die, people are always going to remember that girl, Sidrubi. That girl that was just helping people, you know. And I'll say it again, service to others, it means so much to me. Because you feel so good. You feel so good in yourself when you help somebody. You make somebody's day. You know, give them hope. That's another reason why I love posting my before and after. You know, people are like, aren't you embarrassed? Look at how your body used to look, or look at how you look, or whatever. I'm not, because I know there is so many people that look like me or look similar to me, and they feel so hopeless and despondent that they don't know that they could change their life too, you know. And despite who says what, you guys who are my true followers know that none of that shit is true. And I'm gonna keep doing me. I'm gonna keep doing me and leaving my legacy, which is Sidrubi, you know, helped women, empowered women. Hence, when I created this corporation, why I made sure that my slogan says Sidrubi Corporation Empowering Women. And we're gonna continue with that. So, let's talk a little bit again about things that are not included with your Sidrubi quote. No matter your doctor, most doctors don't include these things. When you come down here, you might be in for surprise. So we talked about not being healthy, not getting your test work done, coming down here and having to see specialists, different people, different tests, and paying for that, paying for the driver, paying for more days at the recovery house, paying these different doctors and paying these different clinics and stuff or whatever for the different labs. Your meds, antibiotics, Tecosol, Presiderm, blood thinners. If you guys don't know, you should be getting a blood thinner shot from your doctor as a prescription, one every day for at least 7 to 10 days. Stage 2 Faha, not included. Usually it's not included. I'm happy I caught this live because I missed the one you did earlier. Oh, thanks, babe. Stage 2 Faha, typically it's $150 plus alteration. Guys, no matter who say what, I don't give a shit. I am not endorsing people. You guys know when I put my stamp of approval on somebody, on an item or something, it's because I tried it, I tested it, and it works for me. The only Faha brand here in DR that I am going to endorse, and no, I do not get anything from these people. I don't get no money, I don't get no commission, I don't get nothing. I love their Faha because that's what I've been using to shape my body, mold my body, and so forth. I met with the owner the last time I was here, I think in May, and I asked him, I want to promote your stuff on my page, but will you give my people a discount when they come and they mention Sidrubi is who sent me? I am not getting anything from it. The people are giving you guys a discount. I'm not getting that money. Right? They're already cutting their profit by giving you guys a discount for saying my name. So Fahati. Fahate, Fahate, Fahate. I have tried different Fahas. I have tried the great Alexander Faha. Wasted my $220 because I like his Faha maybe. And I wouldn't even say maybe. No, let me don't say that. Because when I got the Faha was December. I've been 2 years plus at that point post-op. My body is not changing dimensions, shape, measurements because I'm not swollen. And the Faha stretched out. Within a week of me wearing it, the Faha started ripping where the bra part is sewn in, the hook started breaking, things like that. So he may be mad, people may be mad, he's mad, Sidrubi is saying don't buy his Faha. It is what it is. I'm not gonna lie for anybody, I don't give a shit who you are. Fahate, which is in the same plaza as him, is the Faha that has been tried and true. Those hooks, they bend, none broke, but they did bend and got crazy, and I had to get the entire hook replaced. It's like a whole panel that they remove and sew back in. But I have to say the hooks didn't break, but they did bend and got crazy. The Faha fabric, when that shit is altered to fit your body, that thing does not budge at all. That Faha stays in place. So your foams, your boards, your backboard, all of that should not move at all. When you go to sleep and wake up, them boards should not have moved, because that faja, like, it just keeps you in. And let me give you guys a little example, because I think this is common sense, but obviously some of you guys that like to talk shit on the internet about me don't have common sense. If you sprain your ankle, right, and your ankle is swollen and fat, when you go to the doctor or whoever, do you not bandage your ankle really tight to get that swelling to go down? Or do you put like a mediocre ass, I don't know, soft bandage on your foot that hanging on and falling off? You bandage your ankle really tight to get that swelling to go down, right? You ice it and then you bandage it, right? So why would people who have plastic surgery and is ridiculously swollen talk shit and says, you're not supposed to wear your faja tight because you're going to damage your body and you're going to damage your results and you're going to damage this? That's common sense, Alicia Rodriguez. That's common sense. I don't care who the hell you went to that told you this dumb shit. You are supposed to wear your faja nice and tight if you want that swelling to go down and you want that shape and that body to start forming and your results to start coming in. So, for me, Fajate is the brand, guys. Let me just adjust this a little better. Fajate is the brand. I have tried Alexander. I have tried the other one that I like, but I only like this after your swelling is done and you just wear it for keeping like the shape and the body is oh gosh, and I like wearing it, you know. How am I gonna forget to tell you guys the name? I get it in Miami all the time. Let me think about that. Because the store is called Fajasi Mas, but the brand, I want to tell you guys what the brand is called so you guys can buy it online. But why I like this one is because it has a lot more lycra and stretch. So me, when I was doing trucking, you know, jumping in another truck, moving around a lot, the faja was, I would say, on a scale of 1 to 10, it was maybe an 8, whereas Fajate is like a 10 out of 10. Niptak says, not sure if this was covered, but is it truly necessary to bring our own medication? I am worried about mixing meds. Is the medication provided by the surgeon not enough? So what you need to bring is, I would say, your supplements for your iron, because remember, after surgery your hemo is going to be going down, especially if you're just doing a lot of lipo. So you want to build back your iron. So bring your iron stuff, which is whatever you're taking for iron. Personally, I tell my people all the time the three things that I say to take, and I'm glad I said that because I need to order it on Amazon and have it sent here to the DR, is the multivitamins that has all your vitamins in it, the Spartone, and then the SSS tonic. If you guys want to take tablets, that's up to you. I personally don't like tablets. Everything I just said there was liquid, and I like liquid because it absorbs better into the body than tablets. Now, medication that your doctor does not provide is painkillers. Here in the DR, they do not give you anything strong at all, so you need to bring your own painkillers, whatever, Vicodin, Percocet, Motrin 800, whatever. I'm not big on meds. You guys know I try to live as holistic a life as I possibly can. So I don't take all that crazy stuff. But if I do have to take something, when I had my really heavy, heavy, painful periods, I used to take Motrin 800. I think Motrin 800 and Ibuprofen 800 is, I guess, the same inactive ingredient. Sometimes when I had ridiculous pain, I would take two, to be honest with you. Make sure and eat something, guys. When you're taking all these meds and pain meds, eat something. Don't just take it just like that, please. Rachel asks, who does teeth out there, veneers, and do I have recommendations? Yes, I do, Rachel. And if you go to, right now in the recovery house, if you go to the IGTV, you will see the doctors are tagged in there. Dr. Lori is the doctor that I personally use. I keep saying I need to make an appointment to go see her, and I am yet to make time to go see her because I need to go get a cleaning. But she does, I think she does beautiful work. She did my teeth whitening for my husband and myself before, and a cleaning. She will give you a discount for mentioning that surgery sent you. When you click on her profile, go click on her name, and I follow her too, so you can go look and see who I'm following and you'll see her name. Dr. Lori Hernandez is her name. You'll see her WhatsApp number and WhatsApp her and let her know that I referred you, and she will give you a discount. She's also doing bichiectomy now, which is the buccal fat removal. So she's doing that, I think, for like 600. So definitely, if you want to do that too, make sure and ask her about it. So we did, we covered painkillers, not even prescribed. So not even prescribed. Antibiotics, blood thinner shots, not given to you. You have to pay for that. Stage 2 Faha, boppy pillow. You either bring one. I like the DR ones. If you bring the one from home, I feel like those ones are so small. Like they get flat really quick. The DR ones, I love those. I met with the boppy pillow manufacturer and the Faha manufacturer. And I want to introduce that to my brand as well. But guys, time. There's not enough time in the day. So hopefully soon, I will get that organized and I will have my own boppy pillow at the Recovery House selling, where, like I said, I love the DR boppy pillow because it's nice and fat and padded. It does not get flat quick and fast. Blood transfusion. Typically, it's about $300. With, for example, like Dr. Rami, you pay the $300 when you pay for your surgery, and then if you don't need a transfusion, you're refunded $280 because the $20 is like the reservation fee that they give the blood bank to secure whatever is your blood type. So you may want to think about that. You may need a blood transfusion. Some people need multiple bags of blood. Usually I think the $300 is for two bags, if I'm not mistaken. Pain pump, since you don't get pain meds. I personally never took the pain pump, but some of my girls have, some of you guys who are my followers, you know, took it and told me that they think it works. Some people say they don't think it works. If you guys don't know, the pain pump has nothing to do with your surgeon. This has everything to do with the anesthesiologist. The anesthesiologist is the one who comes up with whatever is the concoction that goes into the pain pump. And how much of what to give you. And I mean, that's their job, right? Because they're the ones that's putting you to sleep and keeping you asleep during your surgery. And they're there in the room. Like, I remember waking up for both my surgeries, and where was the anesthesiologist? Right here. Literally right behind my head. Because I opened my eyes and I'm looking around and I'm talking, and he was right there. And I remember him because he came and did my pre-admission. So I know who I was looking at. So yes, your anesthesiologist is in the room with you. He's the one that is going to be getting that $300, not your surgeon, when you do the pain pump with them. We talked about if you have sickle cell anemia, the trait or the disease, and you don't come with your letter of clearance from your hematologist, and you don't come with your paperwork showing that you did your various tests, which is on Surgery Bay, the Instagram page. I put up there what test it is that you need to go and get done, specifically PTT and all these different things, and bring that with you. That's it, I think, for additional testing. The additional, not testing, additional costs that you may have. Remember, anything that sets back your surgery, you may have to stay longer in the DR, which means more money at the recovery house, more days at the recovery house. Unless you want to say, fuck it, I'm going home early, and you go home, you know, 7 days post-op, whatever. And then, guys, if you do that, make sure you have somebody who is honestly experienced in post-op care. Not somebody who says, yeah, I do lymphatic massages, yeah, I'm a masseuse, and they don't know what they're talking about. I've had people that did that where they went home, had their friend who's a masseuse do their massages, and the friend is a regular masseuse, not a professional lymphatic therapist. So what happened to her? Her tummy tuck, and she went to Miami for this tummy tuck too. She didn't come DR. Her tummy tuck incision, and I'm telling her, your belly is swelling with fluid. I'm seeing it. Your faha is too loose. This lady's wearing a faha that is like so stretchy that you pull it and you're seeing the big space in the faha. Like, why are you even wearing a faha? It's not even doing anything. And she wouldn't listen to me. And guess what happened? One day she's in the shower, and literally the fluid buildup in her stomach had to find a way to come out. And a corner of the incision busted open, and she was standing there in the shower for half an hour with fluid just pouring out of her. And what did she have to do? Start putting a baby diaper to catch all that fluid in her side. And her friend, not, what do you call it? Not a licensed lymphatic masseuse, just a regular masseuse. So the lady didn't know what she was doing. Let me see what you guys are saying. Yes, Pedro Lopez, though, you can bring CBD gummies because honestly, that's gonna help you sleep as well. Guys, bring Tylenol PM with you. That's over the counter. That's 500 milligrams. Honestly, it puts you to sleep. And if you really need to, eat something and take three. 1500 milligrams of pain meds. It's gonna put your ass to sleep and dull that pain for at least maybe a good 6 to 8 hours or so. When I told you guys earlier what I used to do, I mean, you know, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a medical professional. I'm just telling you all what I did. If you all do it, if you all don't do it, that's up to you. You have to make that choice. Those horrible period cramps I had for a good 8-10 hours, you know. So, and then Touch Body Studio is saying, don't go home early. I have tons of horror stories. If you guys don't know, Touch Body Studio is a post-op caregiver. When you come back home, you guys can go check out her page and see, you know, she knows what she's talking about, obviously. And yes, I'm going to save the life. I can put it on YouTube for you guys. So I don't know how long Instagram is going to give me. You know, sometimes they cut me off after hours. Sometimes I can go long, whatever. So I'm going to end it here because we were talking about what if additional charges you may have, that be prepared for it. Bring additional cash, guys. Bring your debit credit card. Bring, honestly, I would say if you can afford it, bring at least $1,500 to $2,000 in cash extra with you. Make sure on your debit credit card you have at least the same thing, $1,500 to $2,000 extra with you, because you can use your debit credit card for the pharmacy. If you need to go to the supermarket, at the Faha store, if you need to go to do any kind of additional testing at a particular lab, they may allow you to pay with card. The only time, honestly, I feel like you must have pesos is where they will not take US dollar and they will not take a debit or credit card. Vendors on the street. We have here what is called the Colmado, and I actually live right downstairs. Sorry, right downstairs from where I live, my building has one. So it's so super convenient just to call them or go right next door. Literally go downstairs and get whatever you need. It's like a corner store. They sell almost everything you could think of, like groceries wise. So you need snacks, whatever. Like one girl, this was the dirty one I was talking about, wanted, I don't know, some kind of snack from the Colmado, whatever. Well, the Colmado is only going to take pesos. They're not going to take US dollars. So how are you paying for your snacks? And I don't know, she wanted some kind of junk food, whatever. And I told you guys, I do not provide junk food. I don't provide anything with preservatives, whatever. Everything is freshly cooked daily. I'm going to do a live one of these days with my refrigerator so you guys can see. There is no shit in the fridge that's in containers, whatever, that we're going to microwave for y'all. Everything is cooked fresh daily. The chef cooks everybody's meals and breakfast, lunch, dinner, and your snacks daily. All the juices that are made fresh daily. My staff knows to use how to use the juicer. They know how to use the Ninja, the blender, because some things, you know, we blend it, some things we juice it. Like for example, I'm not gonna call the name of the recovery house. The girl that said this to me, she's like, I'm still there, but I want to do a live with you after so I can talk about my experience. This recovery house, guys, is charging this girl $20. She told me she paid to get some fresh beet juice. And it's not juice from a juicer. It's like they're blending the beets, excuse me. And she sent me the pictures. She sent me the pictures of the WhatsApp conversation. She sent me the pictures of the food that they're serving her and of the juice that she had to pay this $20 US for. Guys, one of my dolls, she just had surgery. Sunday she was discharged. So when I went to church on Sunday, when I got out of church, her mom, who is also, they're both they're mother and daughter. They are both having, they both had surgery at the same time and they're recovering together at my recovery house. So the mom sent me a message and said that the daughter was just discharged Sunday morning, and when she left the clinic, Dr. Lopez, which is one of the doctors I work with, he said that her hemo was an 8, and for her, and she's also a weight loss surgery patient, so it's harder for her to absorb iron, at least synthetic iron. So he wanted her to get, here in the DR, they give you black bean smoothie And we also make like a red bell pepper and carrot juice. Right? So he sent her home with those instructions that he wants her to take that. So now my doll, her and her mom, because I said to her mom, you need to drink this too, because after surgery, remember, your hemo is low. So you need to also build back your iron. So they're getting every day, besides the standard. And I don't know, but like I said, these are the recovery houses that you all think I'm jealous about. No, honey. I can't be jealous of things that are beneath me. Something that is above me. And even that I'm not jealous, I strive to be as good or better. Right? I don't get jealous of other people's success, so to speak. That's motivation for me to be a better person, to be a better businesswoman, for me to do better. I went to the supermarket as soon as I got out of the church, and I got what the doctor prescribed, which is the black beans and the milk to make the shake, and the carrots and red bell pepper. These two poodles that live downstairs, they're going in their car. Loli, Lola's right here with me. Look at the doggy, right there, look. She's so nosy. Sorry, guys. I went and I got the supplies. And I sent the girl who sent me the picture talking about they're charging me $20 US for this whatever. I sent her the receipt, like, look, this is how much this cost me. Like, how unethical is that? To make an extra $20 on somebody? Beats are like 13 pesos, which is, I think it was the package was 13 pesos, or it was 13 pesos a pound, something like that, which is how much sense? Because 56 pesos is $1. 56 pesos is $1. So 25 pesos is 50 cents. So 13 pesos is 25 cents. 25 cents US per pound for beets. And I'm going to charge people $20 to make some juice for them? Come on, guys. This is why people hate surgery. This is why. Because I bust the nonsense. I bust the mark, as we say in Trinidad. I put the truth out there for you guys to know. This is how people are coming over on you guys. That's, to me, that's not cool. Anyway, I will have to do a video up here and post it on the page so you guys can see exactly what I'm talking about. So the red bell pepper and the carrots we're juicing in the actual juicer for her so that there is no pulp. And then the beets, the green juice, the ginger tea. If you guys recover houses, I'm not giving you guys this. So sad, so sorry for y'all. But green juice and ginger tea are two standard things at my house daily. There is no ifs, ands, or buts. You need to drink at least one green juice a day and ginger tea once to twice a day. If you guys don't know why, because ginger is a natural blood thinner, which helps you with not getting a blood clot and dying after surgery. Because we don't know when you get a blood clot, where it's going to travel into your body. So those are standard things at my house. There is no extra charge for that. There is no, you know, oh, we don't have it, let me have to go out and try and buy it, whatever. Things like dessert, ice cream, brownies, flan, whatever you guys want, my chef makes it. Right now, I saw when I was there yesterday, he made some flan, like a two-layer something with strawberries and whatever, and he had it chilling in the refrigerator, because those things have to be kept clean, cold. So you have a sweet tooth, you feel for whatever, as long as it's not something like